But who was to blame? All the experts had an answer.
Angry, heavy metal subculture.
Where were the parents?
Violent movies.
South Park.
Video games.
Television.
Entertainment.
Satan.
Cartoons.
Zoom.
Society.
Toy guns. Drugs.
Shock rocker. Marilyn Manson.
Marilyn Manson.
Marilyn Manson.
Marilyn Manson.
Marilyn Manson.
Marilyn Manson has canceled the last 5 dates of his U.S. tour out of respect for those lost in Littleton. But the singer says artists like himself are not the ones to blame.
This is perhaps the sickest group ever promoted by a mainstream record company.
After Columbine, it seemed that the entire focus on why the shootings occurred was because the killers listened to Marilyn Manson.
If you were to talk directly to the kids at Columbine or the people in that community, what would you say to them if they were here right now?
I wouldn't say a single word to them. I would listen to what they have to say, and that's what no one did.
I don't understand why you pick Catholicism, why you go with the cross, with God, with the Pope. To me, she has lost her religion because of listening to him as well as other musicians. She's not a Catholic anymore. She has no religion anymore, and that's what's bothering me.
Well, you know, it could be because it was your religion and maybe it wasn't supposed to be hers.
Okay.
And that most children don't understand what you're doing and why you're using the F word and why you're acting bizarre. And this can be very, very troubling to children who don't have direction, who don't have responsible parents.
Anything can be misinterpreted. People can look at Christ on a cross and think, this is an image of murder, this is violent, this has sexual imagery in it. And it just, I think it's my job as an artist to be out there pushing people's buttons and making them question everything. And I respect you for challenging me, and that's why I came on the show.
You gotta feel the mindset, right? But let me say something though. I've particularly on this record, with the imagery that I use, I tried to look at the things that I was taught growing up about Christianity in a different way. You know, I looked at the image of Christ on the cross and the story of him as someone who was a revolutionary with dangerous ideas, and I started saying to myself, oh, I can relate to this story now. I'm not going to dismiss it, but I'm gonna interpret it in a different way. So everybody should, you know, you have to be open-minded. I'm sure when you were young, you didn't want to listen to what your parents were trying to tell you to believe in. You know, she's going to find her own. Maybe someday she'll become a nun. You don't know.
The two byproducts of that whole tragedy were violence and entertainment and gun control, and how perfect that was the two things that we were going to talk about with the upcoming election. And also then we forgot about Monica Lewinsky, and we forgot about the president was shooting bombs overseas, yet I'm a bad guy because I've sang some rock and roll songs. And who's a bigger influence, the president or Marilyn Manson?
You know,
I'd like to think me, but I'm going to go with the president.
What's your message? What are you trying to get across in the lyrics to these songs?
It's always about being yourself and not being ashamed of being different or thinking different. I try and take everyone's ideals, common morals, flip them around, make people look at them differently, question them so that you're not always taking things for granted.
For example, you do rip pages out of the Bible in your concert. You do wipe your ass with the American flag.
Mm-hmm.
Some of these things, you have to admit, are controversial.
Absolutely.
I mean,
they're designed to make people think, but the point with the Bible or flags is to say it's only as valid as you make it in your heart. A piece of paper.
It's all about perception, isn't it, Marilyn?
A piece of paper or a piece of cloth doesn't mean anything. It's what you believe. And I want people to think about what they believe. I want them to consider if everything they've been taught, if that's what they want to believe or that's what they've been told that they have to believe.
You're a pretty well-spoken guy, yet in your records you use a lot of F-word, a lot of swearing, and this and that. Again, is it necessary?
Sometimes. I think sometimes when you're making a point, I don't think that my lyrics are overlaced with profanity because I myself don't speak using a lot of profanity in normal conversation. But I think when you're making something aggressive and you need to get a point across, if you're angry, sometimes profanity is necessary. It's better to use a curse word than to hurt somebody else, I find. Well, I think if parents spent more time trying to censor rock music and art and movies and things like that, and they spent the time teaching their kids to appreciate and understand those things and to know what's right and what's wrong, I think that's more time spent, more value.
You can take some of your lyrics as, you know, you'll understand when I'm dead. I mean, Disturbed kids could take the lyrics and say, you know, when I'm dead, everybody's going to know me.
Well, I think that's a very valid point, and I think that that's a reflection of not necessarily this program, but of television in general. If you die and enough people are watching, then you become a martyr, you become a hero, you become well known. So when you have things like Columbine and you have these kids that are angry and they have something to say and no one's listening, the media sends a message that if you do something loud enough and it gets our attention, then you will be famous for it. Those kids ended up on the cover of Time magazine. The media gave them exactly what they wanted. And that's why I never did any interviews when that happened, when I was getting blamed for it, because I felt that I would be contributing to what I found to be reprehensible.
So you don't believe that your songs reflect any kind of suicide wish or anything like that?
No, I feel that my songs talk about getting through feelings like that.
No, it's not. It's responsible because I'm telling them the truth.
No sex.
And we haven't told people the truth.
No, you're making an irresponsible
suppression of sex throughout history that's made people so violent.
And women.
You mean because they have,
you're making the irresponsible.
If you feel guilty about having
I've
sex.
I've never known anyone who feels
everybody
you,
wants to have sex. The world is created through sex.
The irresponsible assumption
is
the one that you made is that the teenage children are going to have sex no matter what. That's not necessarily true at all.
No, it's not.
Oh, Gordon.
It's not. You know what?
I had a lot of teenage companions when I was a teenager. Really? And they were not all running around getting laid.
But he was also in prison, so he's got a different...
Well, he was in school and going in a very dark direction that we really didn't understand. We couldn't connect to it. So we pulled him out of school, and he's now homeschooled. And I feel you can't criticize something you don't know anything about, so I went to the concerts with him. I'm convinced that Marilyn Manson is a true rock and roll star.
He's a star!
Thank you. I believe in him.
Well,
and he's helped my son be himself through a lot of adversity and crap. And I know that goes for everybody in this room.
What, if you want to blame rock music for things, think about what the Bible's done. What about Heaven's Gate or Jim Jones or the Ku Klux Klan?
Right.
What they do in the name of Christ.
They totally defy the Bible.
Yeah, but,
the Bible says,
well,
if you love God and hate your brother, you're a liar and God is not in you. Obviously,
right.
You have not read that.
No, I've read the Bible. But I'm just saying what people do in the name of the Bible
is a liar and God isn't in him. So, you know, if we're going to quote
I'm
the Bible,
what,
you
what
complain
people
that people take you
God.
Out of context. Don't take the Bible out of context.
Oh, but...
Context, he's taking Friedrich Nietzsche out of context. That's what
right.
But the Bible certainly has been the inspiration for an amazing amount of un-Bible-like activity.
I like the Bible. I'm just saying I don't like the way people misuse it just as much as people could misuse
it. If you like it, then be the standard and do it. That's the problem.
I like
the
it as a book,
the majority
just like I like
of people
the Cat in the Hat.
Say there's something and they're not.
Do you know that the day that Columbine happened, United States dropped more bombs on Kosovo than any other time during that war?
I do know that, and I think that that's really ironic, you know, that nobody said, well, maybe the president had an influence on this violent behavior. No, because that's not the way the media wants to take it and spin and turn it into fear, because then you're watching television, you're watching the news, you're being pumped full of fear. There's floods, there's AIDS, there's murder, cut to commercial. Buy the Acura, buy the Colgate. If you have bad breath, they're not going to talk to you. If you got pimples, the girl's not going to fuck you. And it's just this, it's a campaign of fear and consumption. And that's what I think that it's all based on, is the whole idea that keep everyone afraid and they'll consume.
What standards do you have and where do you draw the line as far as what is good and what is evil?
I have basic principles that kind of exist in all religions,
such
even
as,
Christianity.
Such as?
Well, the fundamentals, you know, you don't kill people, you're a basic good person.
Okay, so...
Probably
you
the same as yours.
Do you... No, they're not the same. Guarantee they're not the same. You are a minister of the, you know, of the Church of Satan.
I'm not a minister of any.
Okay, because I don't know. Rolling Stone, I've heard that you were into the Church of Satan. I assume that you read the Satanic Bible by Anton LaVey.
I read both Bibles.
Okay.
Christian Bible. Too.
Right. Okay, and we know that the Bible has 10 commandments, not 10 suggestions.
Right.
And there's one commandment in the book of Satan. What is that commandment?
I don't know. I don't preach.
Chill, like eat a bar.
You don't? They would like to.
I mean, I follow basic principles like anybody else would.
What people don't see is that when you're a 14-year-old or a 16-year-old and you go to his concert, it enunciates what you're feeling. Do you remember what you felt like at that age? I do.
Yeah, I want to bug my parents.
No,
that's